I'm not sure if the stock market is pricing it in happening right now. I mean, there's no scoreboard that I can tell you definitively it's being priced in, but I don't think it's in there. So if you do get something, I think it'll be good for sentiment, and I think it'll probably lead to new highs. But if you don't, I'm not sure it'll be as big of a disappointment as maybe I would have thought a month ago. But I think big picture, a lot of what's been working for the last 6 months continues to work. I'm focused on the XHB, ITB, been talking about the housing stocks all year. Lowe's in particular in that index, LOW, looks primed for a mega breakout. It's about to take out previous resistance. Put that one on your radar. And then there's some leadership from energy today, which is kind of weird. We were looking at some of these names, and Exxon could double from where it's trading right now and still be negative on the year. That's how beaten up this sector is, and so that's a big mover today. I don't think that these things are happening based on stimulus. The one stock that might be, I want to point out, Discover Financial. This is the Discover card. It's probably the best bellwether for what we're thinking about in terms of the consumer. Stock's up 100% over the last 6 months. It's just absolutely ripping. And I think when you see activity in Discover, which has some of the lowest credit quality versus, let's say, American Express, I think that's a good indicator that markets are not terribly concerned that there's going to be a substantial downturn in consumer. That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah. Shan, how do you play this? How do you judge what's happening in Washington with stimulus and what it means to the stock market? I mean, you certainly see the gyrations today alone, you know, a headline here, headline there, market up, market down.
I think this played into some of the volatility that we saw in September, honestly, Scott. So I think some of this, to Josh's point, I feel like coming out of the end of July and into the middle of August, I do think that we were starting to price in or have had expectations of an additional stimulus package. And I think after the death of Justice Ginsburg and the additional contentiousness around the debates, I think that there has been some lost euphoria as it relates to the stimulus. I do want to point out, however, that I'm a bit more concerned about this K-shaped recovery. And I know that that won't necessarily translate to the stock market in the very near term, but I'm concerned about the overall level of consumer activity, given the fact that we have a much lower participation rate than we had previous to COVID. And so if we look at the consumer, I think we're getting two classes of consumer activity right now. And without the stimulus, I think that that continues to diverge. And so I think that that can play into some of the retail exposure that you might have in your portfolio, but also as it relates to consumer confidence and sentiment as we move forward through the end of the quarter.
I mean, you're saying K-shaped recovery. Joe Lavorgna from the White House Economic Office was on. They're maintaining, the White House is, that you have a V-shaped recovery, in their words, self-sustaining V-shaped recovery, Shan. So I don't know if, you know, that takes some of the urgency, at least from the White House's perspective. Certainly maybe some Republicans in the Senate, as Jim Cramer has been talking about, don't seem to be feeling a sense of urgency, because there's a wide swath in Washington, at least within the party of the Republican Party, that believes we're having a V-shaped recovery.
Well, I think it's the people that have a voice and the people that are vocal and the people that are outspending in large en masse. I mean, you look at the holiday shopping season, if you look at the, you know, different demographic groups, you know, they're the wealthier individuals in our economy are going to be spending more this year because they haven't been spending any money on vacations or other discretionary spend. I still think that there's going to be a come to Jesus moment, really, for, you know, the working class Americans who were relying on stimulus, expanded unemployment benefits. And you and I both know, Scott, that a lot of these small businesses are not coming back. And we're going to continue to see more closures as we go through the end of the year. And so I think that Washington should start paying more attention to working class Americans, because this is going to continue to be an issue for household income at large.